Alright guys, so we just talked about how you can use aqueous acid to add alcohols to double bonds through acid-catalyzed hydration. But it turns out that there's actually more than one way to add alcohols to double bonds, and that's actually a huge focus of this section. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you guys an alternate reaction that we could use that also adds alcohols to double bonds, and it's called oxymercuration-demercuration. So first of all, what you're going to notice is that this is just a really long name for a reaction. So I personally like to shorten it. And I always call it, instead of that long name, I usually just call it oxymerc. And that's fine. If you just say oxymerc, that just means it's oxymercuration, demercuration, or reduction. It's fine. Okay? So in general, what do we see? Like, what's the general reagents that we use for this? What we're going to find is that you have a double bond, of course. And then we're going to react it with this weird reagent that's a mercury with two acetate or acetyl groups on it, okay? So that's what OAC means. It means acetyl groups. And I'll show you what that looks like in a second. So you have that, and you have water. So this is really the first step, and this is called the oxymercuration step. Now, if you're confused, like, how you'd remember this, well, eventually you are going to need to memorize this. But one way that I like to maybe make it simpler is that notice that the word oxymercuration has mercury in it, mercury. And notice that the reagent of oxymercuration is Hg, which is mercury. So if, whenever you just see the Hg, you automatically know this is an oxymercuration. In fact, we won't see any other reactions with mercury until Orgo 2. So you're pretty safe that if it's a mercury, that's oxymerc. Okay? Then the second step of this is to react with NaBH4 and some kind of base, like NaOH. This is called the reduction step or the demercuration step, okay? Now, typically, that's the way things work. When you have something above the arrow and something on below it, that could either mean that you have a reagent and it's solvent, or that you just have a two-step reaction. Sometimes you're going to see these written as separate steps, like 1 and 2, but sometimes you'll just see it written without the numbers, and you're just supposed to know that what's on top of the arrow is the oxymerc part, what's at the bottom is the reduction part, okay? Regardless, we're going to learn these reagents, don't worry. But regardless, look what happens. We still get an alcohol. So let's go ahead and look at the general feature of this mechanism. So basically, the intermediate for oxymerc is not going to be the same as hydration. Instead of being a carbocation, what it's going to be is what we call a bridged ion, okay? And that's going to be a big deal when it comes to predicting products. That's actually going to matter a lot, okay? The stereochemistry here is actually going to matter. It's going to be decisively anti, okay? So what that means is that anti-stereochemistry is the same way as saying that at the end, you're going to get trans products, okay? So if you ever hear me say anti, that just means that at the end, you're going to expect your alcohol and your H to be trans to each other, okay? And like I just told you guys, the products are alcohols, okay? So now let's come to the last two facts. Would we expect there to be rearrangements in this mechanism? Remember that rearrangements happen when we have carbocations. Do we have a carbocation? No. So it turns out that this reaction is actually not going to have any rearrangements because it doesn't have any carbocations. So I'm just going to write that right here. No carbocation. Okay, so there's actually no way for it to rearrange at all. Finally, is it going to follow Markovnikov regiochemistry? Yes, it is. Markovnikov's rule is still going to apply. Even though it's not a carbocation, it's still going to apply. All right? So now when we look down at our general product, it actually makes sense what it looks like. Notice that what I have, oops, just a second. Notice that what I have is that, once again, this is my Markovnikov location, and I attached my alcohol to it, okay? So my alcohol is going to go Markovnikov. On top of that, notice that the H that I added on the other side is going towards the dash, and the OH is going on the wedge. What that means is that I have a Markovnikov anti-alcohol. Does that make sense? Because basically, it's Markovnikov because it went to the most stable location. It's anti because my H and the OH that I added are trans to each other, and it's an alcohol. All right? So even if you didn't know the full mechanism, you could still predict the products just based on these facts. But obviously, we need to know the mechanism, so let's go ahead and get started with that.